So, good evening, everyone, and welcome Professor Arun Dutta Sahab for delivering this wonderful unconventional talk on holistic dermatology. He's a very well-known dermatologist and a very senior person from Kolkata. And actually, needs no introduction, but it's a formal way of introducing our speakers. So, Professor Dutta had been professor and head at several institutes and medical colleges in Calcutta, including IGP, IPG, MER, and SSKM Hospital, North Bengal Medical College, and Calcutta National Medical College. He has been very active in academic forums, and he has been a chairperson of Aesthetica Asia Conference. He has been a national president of Indian Association of Leprosy, past national president of Indian Association of Sexually Transmitted Diseases and AIDS, also past national vice president of IADBL, past president of IADBL West Bengal branch. He has been a president service organization for upliftment of living, that is SOUL. He has been on the editorial advisory board for several reputed journals, including Pigment International, Indian Journal of Dermatology, Indian Journal of Sexually Transmitted Diseases and AIDS. He is also a peer reviewer of several journals, including IJD, IJDBL, GMAT, etc. He has been a postgraduate examiner and a paper setter for several universities across the country. He has also been a past chairperson for Board of Dermatology in West Bengal University of Medical Sciences, past member of Academic Committee, Kolkata University. He has, to his credit, several publications, to be precise, 36 in several reputed national journals and international journals. He has been an instrumental figure in upgrading the Department of Dermatology and starting PG seats in the IG, IPG, MER, resource person in many regional, national, and international conferences and congresses. His chief interests include vitiligo, acne, aesthetic, cosmetic dermatology, holistic dermatology, and he has been working on arsenicosis also. And he is also a member of our geriatric dermatology SIG for the year 2020-21. So, Professor Arun Dutta, welcome once again, and I request you to start your presentation. The screen is all yours now.
Thank you, Lalit ji, and Jai Ho. Instead of good evening, I say Jai Ho, because good evening is only for the evening, or good morning is only for the morning. Jai Ho means be happy and you should get success every time. Anyway, the topic is slightly different from the others, Jara Hatke. It's holistic dermatology. Basically, it has come from holistic medicine. Holism. Holism is a general term. Whether in science, sociology, economics, linguistic, or philosophy, it is the idea that all the properties of a given system cannot be determined or explained by its component parts alone, but the system as a whole determines in an important way how the parts behave. And that is very important. You can see in Hyderabad, there's a Sri Sri Holistic Hospital, which is a leading multi-speciality hospital with quite a few branches. Head office is in Nizampet, Hyderabad. You can see two ladies there. They are MD dermatologists attached to that. So holistic has already started. This is in India, in Gujarat. Last year, 31st March 2019, they had a Dharma Practice CME on holistic approach to practice perfectly. The holism has already come. Let's see the meetings and conferences which was held and which is being held throughout the world if possible. October 9, 2019 in Makati Medical Center in Philippines. They had the multifaceted dermatology, a current holistic approach. This was a webinar sort of a thing. holistic dermatology, which was going on. I don't know the date. Holistic plastic surgery show. It is a holistic dermatology, how to get healthy and youthful skin. This was there. Now we come to this year's meeting. The problem with this year is that we cannot have physical meetings, so most of them are having webinars. And this is also a Zoom meeting, which was held in April 28th this year. Now we come to another one, which was held in June 22nd and 23rd. That is Advances in Natural Medicine, Nutraceuticals, and Neurocognition. In nursing, there is also holistic, 6th World Holistic Nursing Conference, which will be held in August 13 and 14 in Dubai, UAE. In October and November, there will be a conference in Sacramento, USA on Integrative Dermatology Symposium. So you can see that this holistic dermatology is there, active and kicking. Let's see if we get something in the publications and journals. Alan Gattner has written a book on holistic dermatology, a new model for dermatology. And it is basically on radiant skin from the inside out. Another one published by Wiley Blackwell, and that is Advances in Integrative Dermatology. It deals with radiant skin from inside out, the holistic dermatologist's guide to healing your skin naturally. Integrative dermatology book. And you can see there's one Indian, the last author, Reena N. Rupani. Even the BJD had a publication, A New Era in Holistic Care, Bridging the Gap Between Dermatologists and Oncologists for the Treatment of Malignant Melanoma, which was published in 22nd January 2018. This is an online journal of nursing, and the topic was Treating Skin Conditions, A Holistic Approach in Dermatology, which was published in March 2020. This was published in 4th September 2012, A Synopsis of Holistic and Integrative Dermatology to 2011, which was conducted in the Department of Dermatology, Kasturba Medical College, Manipal. So see, it has come in India since the end, the beginning of this decade. This is another journal, Open Access Macedonian Journal of Medical Sciences. You can see a red circle with the name Torello Lotti. He's a professor in Rome, Italy. He has visited our country many times to give many presentations all over the country. His article, The Integrative Dermatology, Use of Herbals and Nutraceutical Supplements to Treat Dermatological Conditions, which was published in 2018. In that it was written. So now you see this one, Integrative Dermatology is relatively a new term coined to describe treatment therapy that combines complementary medicines with dermatology in the treatment of dermatological condition. It was first explored in Fitzpatrick's Dermatology in General Medicine, chapter 241. The chapter was Complementary and Alternative Medicine in Dermatology, and that was published in 2007. So Fitzpatrick also has a mention of this holistic dermatology. Now, the author stated that complementary and alternative medicine, which is called as CAM, in dermatology encompasses a wide variety of methods of diagnosis and treatment that either supplement or substitute for the conventional dermatologic practice. Its diagnostic and therapeutic choices are made by combining these three knowledge bases in what might be termed as integrative dermatology. Now is the time for integrative dermatology. So in the late 70s or 80s, the main treatment option for dermatological conditions were exclusively in the domain of mainstream or conventional medicine. That is what we use today. However, in some Western countries, complementary alternative medicines have become more popular. In the United States, the number of visits to complementary alternative medicine practitioners have grown rapidly. That was in 1990, it was 427 million. And in 1997, it was 629 million. It is estimated that between 50 to 75% of US population is using some form of alternative medicine at a given time. So you can understand the value of this holistic approach to health, which we also need to incorporate. Now let's come to the holistic treatment. When there's no holistic treatment, the treatment is what we give with the conventional medicine, but you have to add something to give value for money and to give confidence to the patient. Dermatologists usually have a lot of patients. Most of them have to visit different hospitals or clinic every day. Thus, the treatment nowadays is more disease or problem oriented, usually due to the increasing number of patients. So more patient, there's less time. Illness adds to the imbalance in the energy sphere of our physical, emotional, rational, spiritual, and social selves. Illness is concerned with the individual balancing of these energies. So something more needs to be done. And that is where holistic dermatology comes in. So there is a beauty in holistic dermatology. Here, you need to balance these, the mind, the spirit, the body, and invite all aspects of yourself there. Wellness basically is the absence of these things written on the right. It's the absence of depression, absence of agony, absence of the presence of self-confidence, the absence of inferiority complex, the psychological impact, the dissatisfaction, the feeling of marginalization, and sometimes there is disillusionment. So thus, the human touch is needed, which a doctor usually can give. And this human touch is very essential. The term holism was introduced by Jan Christian Smart in 1926 as the way of viewing living things as entities greater than the different form from the sum of their parts. So the whole thing comes, and from the word whole, holistic has come. It wasn't until 1970 that holistic became a common adjective in our modern vocabulary. Jan Christian Smart coined the word in 1926 when he wrote Holism and Evolution after he left his post as the Prime Minister of South Africa, having opposed the growing forces of apartheid in 1920s, the only prime minister to do so until Dr. Nelson Mandela. What is holistic health? This kind of holistic healing often involves multiple complementary medicine and alternative healthcare practices that can overlap with the modern day Western medicines, but will go beyond the singular treatment of symptoms to support more than just the body. This is what is holistic health. This is a definition of holistic health, and this is a quality of life. Quality of life is the overall sense of well-being that has a different meaning for each individual. Let's repeat, the quality of life, overall sense of well-being that has a different meaning for each individual, and that is where you have to probe for the treatment. So holistic health is the harmony and balance in all aspects of health. All aspects means physical, mental, emotional, social, moral, or spiritual. So all has to be incorporated for the health and well-being. It has a few factors. You can see the physical, spiritual, emotional, social, and mental. Now come to physical health. It refers to the state of body, its composition, development, function and maintenance. This is what we usually look into and we treat. Physical health also means the ability to carry out daily tasks without becoming tired. When you become tired with your daily tasks, when you are depressed, when you are anxious, that time your mental setup is not balanced and that is the reason you get tired. So physical health also has that part. So when it comes to supporting your physical health, there are a few key practices that everyone can benefit from and can make a huge difference in your overall well-being. Like sleep 8 hours each night, eat a diet high in plant-based food or organic pastured animal products, or do 30 minutes daily exercise, or limit processed food or hydrogenated oils, and do not smoke, and avoid excessive alcohol consumption. The last line is difficult to maintain, at least for me. Mental and intellectual health. It is a cognitive ability and skills to improve the quality of life. Also, the ability to reason, analyze, evaluate, and make rational decisions. Maintain a positive outlook, especially when dealing with problems and conflicts. Emotional health, our ability to accept and cope with our own and others' feelings. It involves understanding and liking yourself. So emotional health is just as important as our physical health, especially because our emotional health can affect our physical health if it is not prioritized. Ways to seek emotional health: the seek out therapy when needed. The therapy is an essential part of supporting our emotional health and should be utilized wherever necessary. Now, what you should do is practice mindfulness and stress reducing habit that can help you better manage life's daily stresses. So you have to decrease your stress and increase your usefulness. Social health is very important. I think over here, our friend Dinesh is a master, and that is, it refers to the ability to build and maintain harmonious and satisfied relationship with everybody. And thanks to Dinesh, he is our flag bearer in this. Being socially accepted is also connected to our emotional well-being. When people like you, then you also feel good. And that feel-good factor is important. And that is why social health is necessary. Researchers know that the happiest people on earth have deep connection with their friends, family, and community. This is often why religion is connected with happiness, as it can provide a deep sense of community and support, no matter what faith a person chooses. Ways you can support your social health: make time for in-person connection, get involved in your local community work, and also do not be afraid to walk away from friendship and relation that are negatively affecting your health. So if you feel some person is not matching your mind, you're not matching your mentality, it is always better to walk away from them. That will help you to be at peace with yourself, and you can improve your personality in a different way. Moral or spiritual health. Morality and spiritual health is necessary to know the meaning and purpose of life. There is no recommended way to help attain moral or spiritual health. It is more about looking deeply within oneself and understanding one's existence in this world. And this is also very important. When all these complementary therapies come together for holistic healing, a person is much more likely to experience wellness on a deeper level and allows for a more joyful and truly healthy way of living. So alternative healthcare practices that are often found within the realm of holistic health are the general Western medicine, which we use regularly, nutrition, herbal treatment, massage, yoga, meditation, acupuncture, physical therapy, chiropractic therapy, personal training, and also our procedural therapy, which we do that is also a part of holistic healing.
Also,
so the holistic approach addresses underlying causes. What are the patient's needs? Let's understand. To get better, we have to give them the treatment with medical science. To feel better, we need that complementary care which we have to give. And live better, to live better, we have to give them the spiritual, moral support and boost them. That is also important. So, tenets of naturopathic or holistic medicines. These are, we have to do these. What? First, do no harm. Use the healing power of nature, the body's innate healing power. Sometimes you see the animals, when they are sick or ill, what they do? They lie down at a place. They don't eat anything. And just by lying down, doing nothing, nature heals and they become okay. And after some time, they're jumping. So we have to use that nature's healing power. Then treat the underlying cause of the disease, not just the symptoms. Symptoms we can treat, but the disease we have to treat slowly. Treat the whole person, and that is holistic health. And educate the patient about their health and focus on preventing the disease. That is also our duty as a doctor. And that is basically holistic health. The clinical connotations. Skin condition we can treat holistically along with the conventional medicines, or after that as maintenance. That is acne, pimples, rosacea, psoriasis, premature aging, puffiness or dark circles under the eyes, sun damage, dry skin and dandruff, autoimmune disorders, a few, inflammation, rashes, allergies, candida and yeast also, hidradenitis, and many, many others which is not in the list. This is just a collection from wherever he got. Aesthetic dermatology addresses many woes of a patient. Aesthetics is also a part, hybrid way of holistic dermatology, because it doesn't harm. And holistic back column with that is very important. Skin pigmentation, how is it caused? Sun damage, chemotherapy drugs, Addison's disease, melasma, insulin resistance, skin irritation or trauma. These are a few causes of skin pigmentation. And you can see how we can treat along with our medicines. We can do these. There's a whole list. I'm not going into that. You come on the left, the last one, licorice extract. It lightens hyperpigmentation and caused by melasma and sun exposure. And licorice extract, we all know, and it is in our book also. Tomato paste. The British Journal of Dermatology in 2011 found that tomato paste rich in lycopene protected the skin against short-term and long-term aspects of photo damage. Now we come to our nani ki treatment, that is masoor dal. You go to any place, any house where they have a grandmother, they will request their granddaughters to use masoor dal. Masoor dal face masks, which are made from red lentils, are popular as a hyperpigmentation treatment. Though there isn't any evidence to back these claims, red lentils are rich in antioxidants that are known to be good for skin. This, maybe there's no scientific backup as such, but for years on, for centuries, it is being continued. That means that this does have some effect. And that is what you call evidence-based treatment. And that we get from this masoor dal also. To remove dark spot on face and neck. So there is a list aloe vera, buttermilk, apple, cider vinegar, which is slightly sour, and it harms the skin if it is given in a concentrated form. And these are lists, I'm not going into that. Probable reason of darkening of the skin on the inner thighs. You can see chafing during exercise or walking, hormonal imbalance, PCOS, certain medications, sun exposure, dry skin, friction from tight clothing, acanthosis nigricans, diabetes mellitus. The remedies for dark skin of the thighs. You can see the list, I'm not going into that. Then the prevention. The prevention is also there. Because this doesn't need any, you use your or our medical treatment, the conventional treatment. Along with that, we can advise these. And with this advice, we are going doing something extra, which will be of help to the patient. And they'll have more confidence on you as a doctor. So the home remedies to help get rid of dark spots. You can see potato, which is at home, honey, which is at home, buttermilk and tomato juice, lemon juice, oatmeal and lemon juice scrub, milk soap, aloe vera, turmeric powder, milk and lemon juice, turmeric powder, honey oil, papaya and lime juice, sugar cube scrub, onion juice scrub. We have everything in our home. So you can, along with our treatment, you can try it out at home first, and then if you feel okay, then you can ask your patient to carry on with it. To keep acne at bay, those who see frequent outbreaks of acne should avoid oily, spicy, sour and fermented foods, heavily fried cheese, gluey and other kinds of food also should be avoided. Now, along with that, we have to tell them an advice on the diet and lifestyle to increase water intake, manage constipation, avoid irritant cosmetics, and do not squeeze acne. We tell all these, but mostly we tell it casually. We should take some time with the patient and tell these properly. And I can tell you, we can get good results. Let's come to something which is off the box, out of the box. This magic of rice water. I've gone to Imphal, Manipur more than 10 times to take examination for conference, etc., etc., etc. And there, while talking, I found out they use this fermented rice water for their hair and to keep their skin beautiful. Initially, I did not believe on all those things, but slowly I found out that most of the grandmother type of people, the elderly people, they use it, and they started when they were very young. So there, kuch to rahega isme, koi to taakat hai. So I found out, and I am convinced, and that is why I am trying to share with you, so that you can also share with others. Rice water, health benefits. Excellent source of energy, treating various digestive issues, lowering of blood pressure, cardiovascular health, help greatly in Alzheimer's disease, reduce obesity, beneficial in preventing cancer. The truth I do not know. This is what is given there. But I know a few truths which shall come soon. Rice water, benefits of its uses. It is used for hair growth, repair hair damage, add hair shine and volume. It gives a healthy scalp and also a glowing skin. The beauty tips of rice water. Shiny hair, and for acne also you can use it. You have a clear skin and you can treat itchy skin also along with this. Do it yourself face toner with rice water. So these are being used in the West also. Rice water, 1/2 cup, aloe vera gel, 1 teaspoonful, and lavender oil, 5 drops. Mix it, apply and keep, mix it together, keep in a fridge. Take out and apply with a cotton ball. And wash your face with that again. And when your face is still damp, apply some face cream. Maybe whatever you prescribe. So with your prescription, they can use this also. Rice water reduces pore size. It is a skin toner. It is mild for the skin. It brightens skin. It can be a hair mask and it heals acne. So there are so many benefits. You see the result of rice water in this patient. You see the periorbital melanosis. See, it has gone quite a bit. So it should work. You can try it and find out. And you can see the face, rice water before and after. Such a glowing skin. Now, these are being sold in the market in such pack. Rice water brightening 5-step facial kit. It's such a beautiful pack. These are being sold in some places. Rice water is good. The fermented rice water is better. Because fermentation lowers the pH of the liquid and is similar to our air pH. So this is what you can use, fermented rice water. In Bangla we say panta bhat, and in Odisha they say pokol bhato. So only thing which we use, people take pokol bhato, and that water we can use for our hair, for our face, and for our body also, to give glow to our body. How to make rice water? There's a chart which is there. So I'm not going into it. It will take a bit of time. So not very tough. You can use it very nicely. You prepare the rice water and you can use it. Benefits of rice water for hair. You see, protects hair damage, promotes hair growth, strengthens hair root, no more split ends, and balances pH level. You can see the hair this lady has, lush green. Glow is there, luster is there. Direction of use: apply rice water to the hair on the scalp. Leave it for 15 minutes, wash it off with cold water and repeat it twice a week. And that is how you can use this for your hair. For hair growth, how to use rice water for hair growth? It can be used for detangling the hair. It can be used as a shampoo. It can be used as a hair rinse, etc. You can see the shine of the hair because of rice water. It can grow as long as this. This lady uses that. There are two methods and many benefits. To cut the split ends, you can use rice water like this. And the ladies of Northeast, they use this and they get the benefit. Thus, from ages ago till now, they are using rice water for the benefit of their hair and skin. How should we treat our patients as a dermatologist? Nature helps. So we should take the help of nature along with our treatment. Meditation calms and balances the mind as well as the body. So we should try to keep our mind calm and the tension or the disturbance in our mind, the anxiety, that should go off as soon as possible to have a better mental health. The whole person care. There's a chart over here. In the center, you see biopsychosocial. So, biological problem is there, the psychological problem is there, and thus the social problem is also there. So, the whole person care is needed. For the whole person care, we just treat either the dark spot or something. But why? The dark spot is there, it doesn't pain, it doesn't cause any problem. But the look causes the problem. They cannot go out. They cannot meet friends. They feel inferiority complex. They become socially marginalized by themselves only. So this biopsychosocial, the whole thing, the whole person care needs to be attended to, addressed. And that is why the holistic medicine, on the left you can see holistic medicine, that backup should be there. And that should help along with our own conventional medical treatment. What should we do as a dermatologist? We should treat conventionally with our acquired knowledge, find out how it is affecting him or her, identify mental, social issues, counsel accordingly to boost his image and morale. Why? Because as I told you, patient cannot go out, cannot meet friends, has an inferiority complex, can't open up. So these things need to be addressed. And you have to identify, everybody has a different problem. Identify the problem and talk to him. So if possible, you try to touch the patient, not during the COVID season, but later. Because when you touch a patient, he or she gets the confidence that Dr. Saab, hamare liye hai. That is very important. We do treat holistically from within our domain, that is aesthetic lasers, light, peels. They don't have much side effects. So that is a holistic in a way. So our approach for an holistic treatment of our patient, remember, diagnosis may be the same, but each has his own unique problem which has to be dealt accordingly. We do treat patient properly and holistically, but we need to spend some time out to explain how to use the medicine. That may be the expert assistants who you have, they can do it for you. Explain the do's and don'ts, counsel on the lifestyle changes, exercise, yoga, meditation, as and when needed, advice on diets, sunscreens, moisturizer, etc. differently so that they can understand properly its use. Advice on homemade remedies during and also after completion of the treatment for prevention and maintenance. Hand-holding. Hand-holding is very important for a depressed patient or an anxious patient. Hand-holding, if the patient is depressed, anxious or angry, that is also important. And why all these? Because to imbibe the confidence and to boost the morale of the patient. Treat positively to give satisfaction. Reach the mind of the patient to give the confidence. And then they will have a beautiful face. They'll have the confidence, that energy to face this world in a proper and a better way. Once we find your happiness, success will follow and life is really good. The ultimate aim of our life is happiness. We have chosen this profession for the benefit of others and for our satisfaction. That is the main thing in life for us. And thank you. It's done. Dinesh? Hello?
Hello? Yes.
So, any questions?
Thank you very much. It was a really eye-opener and I was trying to tell my wife to prepare some rice, this thing. So, and there was a question whether it should be a this parboiled rice or there was a question in the chat box I was...
Any rice will do. Brown rice or parboiled works, but not that much. Every rice works because the essence inside is good. So, whatever rice you take the rice, put it in water, a small amount of water, wash it first, clean it, add more water, and keep it for 24 hours. Slowly, it will ferment. And how will you know that it has fermented? The color will be slightly cloudy, and there will be a sour smell. That means it is done. Then you can put it in a bottle or a container, and you can use it. That is how you can use the rice. Or rice ban gaya, hum log kha liye, uska baad extra jo hai, usme pani dalo, and keep it overnight. In the morning, you get this rice water. That also will work. That is how.
There's a question by regarding Multani Mitti. Himanshi Khurana wants to ask, sir, does Multani Mitti works for bareness? Obviously, this is a very old
Multani Mitti. I have no idea if the Mitti as such works or
not. I have got an idea, because in our northern side, Multani Mitti is being used for this fairness and all these things. These are that Dadi Ma ke Nuske. They use as a face pack. Yes, Dr. Agarwal, welcome.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
How are you?
Fine, sir. Very nice lecture, sir.
Good evening,
Dr. Agarwal.
Good
evening, sir. Good evening, Dr. Dutta. Sir, I wanted to ask one query. This holiest
yes, Dr. approach.
Huh? That is include, like you said, naturopathy. That yeah. is include the homeopathy and Ayurveda also.
Yeah, because Ayurveda is not something out of the world. It is what our ancestors used to use it. And in Ayurveda, they have incorporated all this. And for centuries, this has come. And you have practically everything. They go into the root cause and treat.
So listen, all pathies, they have got their own system.
Like, right.
Ayurveda, you told that they go to the root. There are five, that vata, pitta, cough, and all these. Homeopathic works on this principle of simile cures simile. And naturopathy has got a different. So all pathies, they have got their basis. And we should not criticize any of these pathies.
Exactly. And, absolutely.
There's no harm in trying or if you've got understanding of the genesis of that. So we have got our dear Bhumesh Kumar is also there on the board.
Bhumesh,
anything?
Good evening, sir. Good evening, all of you.
Good evening, Dr. Bhumesh.
Yeah, good evening, sir. How are you, sir?
Well, fine, thank you.
So, Dr. Agarwal, would you like to add up or anything?
No, it was a very new for me, the holistic approach. And frankly speaking, I've heard the first time this approach in the
truly speaking, holistic approach involves the homeopathic also, involves the Ayurvedic also, involves the naturopathy also, Yunani and other systems also. That is the holistic approach. I never criticize any pathy.
You have always been the you have always been praiser of the homeopathy rather.
Yes, I have seen the miracles of homeopathy.
Miracles of homeopathy. Yes.
Basically, it is called complementary alternative medicine. So
we are
complementing our Western medicine along with the other